Tenemos ahora a Antonio Amador, es de la empresa Brisa. Antonio es ingeniero electrónico, posee un posgrado en dirección de empresas y es considerado como experto en peajes y sistemas de gestión de carreteras. Actualmente, desde hace 5 años, es el director de desarrollo de los sistemas inteligentes de transporte en Brisa, empresa operadora de peajes a nivel internacional. Antonio también ha ejercido de líder en diseño técnico de ITS para instalaciones de peaje y gestión de tráfico, así como de consultor de ITS. Antonio.
Good morning, everybody. First of all, I'm going to give a small introduction to Brisa. Then I will focus in the evolution of tolling in Portugal. Okay, all the plazas evolved, the payment means, and the new electronic toll that now are upcoming in Portugal. Brisa is one of the biggest concessionaires in Portugal. We operate 1,100 kilometers, and for all these kind of operations, the technology is very important. That's why Brisa Innovation exists, and we cover all the network chain. We do research projects in the ITS area in collaboration with the universities. Thank you. And then we develop new solutions, do the installations and the maintenance of the solutions. So coming back to the subject of this presentation, the network in Portugal. If you see Portugal as a rectangle, the network today of highways is, as you can see, well covered. We have highways for almost all the places in the country. From the Brisa network is that you can see over there. Most of that highways are traditional tolls with a toll plaza and the manual cash payment. Some figures now. The first toll was introduced in the 60s, beginning of the 60s, a small toll plaza. Then the introduction of electronic tolls lines was in the beginning of the 90s with the key-free solution. And the all the network is about 2,080 kilometers, which more or less half is traditional tolls. The other half is electronic toll collection only. How is the tax obtained? Basic is in the distance that the procured and based on the classes of the vehicles. We have 4 classes based on physical parameters, the number of axles and the height to the first axle. With this way, you can distinguish between light vehicles and heavy vehicles. The evolution of the solution, we start with open toll roads in urban areas, but as the network grows, we need to connect cities. So the best solution was the closed toll road. This was to minimize the number of the stops that the driver must do. In Portugal, the closed toll roads, we have different concessions. So the driver, when he does a journey, he can pass it through different concessions. So this for instance, e-entrance in concession A passes to through concession B and exit in concession C. The taxi has the three amounts, and so this value must be split between the different concessions. And we must give to the concession, C must give that part A to the first concession and part B to the second concession. That's the problem that we solved, and it's working well in Portugal. Talking about now about the evolution of the payment means, the first method logically was cash, and at the end of the 80s we introduced the payment with the bank cards. At the beginning, only with debit cards, because in Portugal almost every people has one debit card, then credit cards. Then, at the end of the 80s, we start with our first electronic toll lanes, first with the passive tags, where the card just give an identification. Then we introduce the DSRC low data rate tags, where we can use these kind of tags in closed toll lanes, which means that when I enter in one in the highway, I don't need to take a ticket. The entrance is recorded in the onboard unit, the tag. And then at the exit, the entrance was read and the text is automatically calculated. A few years ago, we, in order to prepare the systems to the interoperability, we have necessity to migrate to median data rates onboard units. And so our systems must support the two technologies. Another important point in our system is that you can use the tag system in the dedicated lanes or in other. We have readers in all the lanes, so you can use that on board in any lane. Finally, 2 or 3 years ago, we don't have this automatic cash machines. You will see in the next slide a few details about that. You introduced these machines in the normal manual lanes. So manual lanes, I think all of you already know what you can do in manual lanes where the car must stop because it has a barrier. You can pay by cash, by bank cards, or also by ATC. In the manual lanes at the entrance, you take a ticket, and then at the exit, you can pay in the automatic lane machines that are integrated in the toll booth. Or you can pay using in a cabin and a toll booth normally with a toll keeper. Use this strategy because in the majority of our lanes, during the day you have a toll keeper, and by night or the hours that there is no traffic, The toll keeper goes home, and then the driver can use these automatic machines. So this lane is 24 hours open, always. And also we have some lanes today that some plazas that have nobody. They are always working in this automatic mode. The automatic lanes in Portugal, we have dedicated lanes, so in really, they are single lane free flow. The car doesn't stop. He passes with a velocity about 600 kilometers. And today we have it's an important solution that we have. You can use the readers from different suppliers. The onboard unit is also in multi-vendor, and also the reader that is on the line. Actually, we have more than 2 million onboard units, LDR and MDR. So we have about 4 million cars. It's and about 200 dedicated lanes. Dedicated lanes, which means that the only cars with the onboard units can pass in these lanes. So it's very, very, very. They are very used. Very it's a good commodity. The enforcement. We don't have barriers. The enforcement is done by photo tolling, and I can say that the violators are less than 1%. So we don't use barriers in this kind of lanes. Also, like in the model of Ireland, we have blacklists and the white lists. The white lists for the tags that with contract, and the blacklists are prepared for the interoperability with other countries. The automatic cash machines, in this kind of machine, I already talked a bit. You can pay use all the ways of payment. Cash, coins, notes. We only give exchange in coins. We don't give change in notes and do not recycle them. And if you want, you also can use the ATC. You have a button there where you can push do a ETC transaction. We have about 300 machines installed in our network, and all these lanes are remotely supervised by an operator. We have two operator centers in the, and we manage all the 300 machines that are spread all over the country. With this solution, we reduced a lot of people in the toll plazas. And as I said, in the majority of the toll plazas, we don't have no more people there. So it was reducing in the investment. Here I have a workflow, how the use of bank cards work. Here in Portugal, we have a great advantage because we had the CIPS. CIPS is a clearing house of the bank, the transactions with the bank, the bank cards. So the card, the transaction is generating the toll. The CIPS send the transaction to the bank concession and to the concession, the bank of the concession and to the bank of the card. And then it's a very easy system. And I can tell you that from manual transactions, 60% of the transactions are using bank cards, so you don't you use few cash today, even in manual lanes. So the traditional concessions today, at least in busy concessions, more than 80% of the transactions are and manage. Ou seja, you don't need the intervention of a tollkeeper. So the drivers use mostly ATC lanes or the automatic cash lanes. But we must continue this kind of toll because legislation imposes that the driver has the right to pay in cash if he wants. So you can, at least in these concessions, the oldest concessions, you must continue to we are obliged to accept cash as a payment. Now we are going to change to the electronic tolls only. In the last few years in Portugal, they are built 1,500 kilometers of highways, and this huge amount of infrastructure was not compatible with the traditional tolling. So government decided to introduce the electronic tolls because, as you can see, it's very simple. It consists of amount of gantries and a place where to do a closet, and that's all. This solution has less investment and convenience for the driver, because you don't need to stop. The identification is done when he crosses the gantry, and even for the environment, that's the best solution. In these kind of tolls, only electronic payment is allowed. So the driver can pay by cash. At the entrance of the lanes, the entrance of the highway, there exists this symbol, so the driver can be advised that is in an electronic toll. And before each gantry, we have a panel with the amount that it will pay at that time. Here I have a picture with the concessions that the initially were free pay, but then with the crisis, the government introduced the payment in these highways. This was a little controversial, but now everybody is paying in these highways. This is a closer view of one of them, and here you can see that not all the sections are tolled. These are the positions of the gantries, and the red circles are the exit and entry points. So they were made studies, and they decided to place the gantries just on that point. And as you can see, this highway is about 200 kilometers, and it's not very, very cheap. This is another one in Algarve with the same concept. It's an open road toll. The just some sections are tolled, others are not. So this kind of system is has some advantages. One of the for the driver is that he don't have to stop. He's continues his normal journey. But for the side of the concessions, there are some issues that must be addressed. One of them is the security of sites. As you saw in the picture that I before, normally these sites are placed in the on the country side, and so there are no people around, so they can easily be vandalized. In Portugal, we have some cases. In past, fortunately, not too much, but that's a issue that we must take care. And another point that it's important is due to the classification that exists, the classification of vehicles that exist in Portugal, which obliges us to measure the height to the first axle, the height of the vehicle. As you can measure in a section, is not easy to measure the height of the vehicle. Great accuracy. You can do that with there are several approaches using artificial intelligence or other physical solutions. I can say you that in A23 we installed that solution that is behind the based on laser. And is working well, but it's an issue. Here I have the workflow all the transaction works. The transaction when happens, the transaction in the collection point is sent to the back office of the concession. Then the back office sees if the tag has a contract with an user. In Portugal, the tag user is Via Verde. We only have one. He sends the transaction to that tag user, and then he does the debit into the bank's account client. If he don't have a tag, because in that you can it's possible to have a photo tolling, the photo is sent to our post office, it's CTT, and then the client has time to pay. He can pay it in five working days. So the system is working. I can say it's working fine with some problems, but it's working fine. The last government tried to that everybody has tried to implement the automatic vehicle. The license plate, the automatic vehicle identification, inclusive the onboard units, already have that application, but it didn't succeed. And if the automatic vehicle identification was implemented today, everybody would have an onboard unit, and so the collection would be easier. But he didn't succeed, so people can use photo tolling or even can buy an anonymous tag. But that are some difficulties that can be solved in the near future. Now I'm going to focus on the ways of payment in these electronic tolls. The best choice, I would say, is the using the onboard unit with a contract or without a contract. And then you can also use the photo tolling. But if you use the photo tolling, we have, as I said before, you can pay the go to a store of the post or CTTs or pay shop, and pay that the tax. And just a note is that while in traditional concessions, a photo is all associated with a violator. People that didn't pay, here is a way of payment. So the paradigm has changed. The other way, we have a problem in the beginning of the year with the people that the tourists and the immigrants, they went. And they don't have a traditional toll to pay. Before they have a toll plaza and they can pay in cash. So they went directly in a highway with gantries. They don't know where to pay. And so before the summer, we installed in some borders this kind of machines. Basically, what they do, they associate the license plate of the vehicle to a credit card. Normally, all the tourists and immigrants have a credit card. This association is valid for 30 days, and then they can use in highways. This was a very it's a simple idea, and it was very successful. Another way of payment is the driver can buy a prepaid ticket in specific stores with a fixed charge and use it for 3 days with unlimited number of journeys. But this only works for specific journeys. So we can't use it normally from north of Spain or Porto and in the south frontier from Spain to Faro Airport also. Another way of payment is because this payment is a problem that it doesn't work in the traditional toll plazas. So the tourist he solves the problem in the electronic tolls, but when he goes for a traditional toll plaza, he can't use that way of payment. So we are saying to install this kind of machines also in the borders, and then give to the tourist or to the an onboard unit with a contract. That's what a temporary contract. That what we call Via Verde visitors. So the concept is similar. He introduced the credit card and that machine delivers an onboard unit. And so the onboard unit is associated with that credit card. Instead of the association to the credit card license plate, we associate credit card with the onboard unit. And with this, we can use that tag in all over the network in Portugal. We are now developing a prototype to install it in a border. Another way I placed that solution here because it's available. I think it's not very useful. The idea is that the driver buy a ticket in a store with a code, and then he activated that card via SMS. And then he is going to can so he preloads, he can buy preloaded cards with amounts between 5 euros and 40 euros, and then after the activation the amounts he can use, and also he can use, can activate more cards, but it's not very used in Portugal. So for our point of view, the electronic tolls or the open road tolling is the future, at least the near future, because as I said, in Portugal more than 2 million onboard units exists, and if we succeed with the implementation of the automatic vehicle identification, we think that's that will be the way, the best way to pay tolls, at least in the next years. So we are working for increase the use of the onboard units, because the one of the photo tolling has significant costs in the administrative costs, because you need to have people looking for the license plates and confirm, and then if you can reduce this work, you reduce also costs. One point that we are working now, because we think with the traffic between countries, is the interoperability with Spain. And now, at this moment, we are doing a pilot with the people in Galicia, where the drivers from Galicia can use their own onboard units. They don't need to buy a Portuguese onboard unit. They can use the Spanish onboard units in our tolls, and vice versa. Technologically, the solution is already implemented. The problem is the business model. But now we are doing a pilot at north of the country. And for tourists and for people that does not come for Portugal too many times, you think the easy toll can be a good easy toll or visit toll, that machines that supply tax can be a good option. There are some references you can consult to see these problems about electronic toll. The first link is, I think it's very good for you if you want to understand how do you deal with the electronic toll. And that's all. Thank you.